Let's create a V-Belt Step Pulley in the Autodesk Fusion. So to create this, we use the Sketch Revolve features and extrude the cut. So open your Fusion and let's go. The first step to create this part here, we'll select the right plane and make this sketch. And the first thing that we make, we'll create a line here, a construction line. We don't have the dimensions of this line, okay? And we will create another line here. And the distance between these two lines will be 9/2, okay? So open the Fusion, go to create a sketch, select the right plane, select line, a construction line, make a construction line here. And make another line here, remove the construction line type. Go to sketch dimension, select constraint, sorry. Select this point in this one, select this point in this one. Go to sketch dimension. The distance between these two lines is 9/2. Okay, we made this, okay. Now, let's create this line here and this one. The distance between this point and the midpoint here is 30/2. And the distance of this line here is 12 millimeters of length, okay? So select line, go to sketch dimension, the distance here 12 millimeters, and the distance between this point and this one is 30/2, okay? Now let's create this line, the distance between this point here, let me make a zoom here. The distance between this point here and the midpoint is 35/2. So I'll select a line, make a line here, go to sketch dimension, the distance here is 35/2. Now let's create this line, this sketch here, okay? It is something like this, okay? And the angle between these two lines is 40 degrees. The length of this line is 6 millimeters. And the distance between this line and the midpoint here is 18/2. So select line, click here at this point, make this sketch. Go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point and this one, and select equal, select these two lines here. The angle between these two lines 40 degrees. This line here has 6 millimeters. And the distance between this line and this line here, the midpoint, is 18/2. And go to constraints and select equal, select this line and this line here. And the distance between this point here and this point here is 14 millimeters, okay? So go to sketch dimension, the distance between these two points, 14 millimeters. Okay, we made this. Now, we made this sketch here. Now we created this line, and the distance between this point and the midpoint is 45/2, okay? So select line, click at this point, make a line here, sketch dimension, the distance here is 45/2. Okay, now we'll create the same sketch here, the angle here 40 degrees, the length of this line is 6 millimeters, but the distance between this line here and the midpoint is 25/2. So select line, click here, make this sketch, go to constraint, select equal, select this two line here, and select this two line here, go to horizontal vertical, select this point and this point here, go to sketch dimension, the angle between the two lines 40 degrees, the length here 6 millimeters, and the distance between this line and the midpoint is 25/2, and the distance between this point and this one is 14 millimeters, Okay. We made this. Now we need to create this line, and the distance between this point here and the midpoint is 55 over 2. So select the line, click here, go to sketch dimension, the distance here is 55 over 2. Now select the line, we'll create the same sketch here, but the distance between this line here and the midpoint will be 37 over 2. Select the line, make this sketch here. Go to constraint, select equal, select these two line, select these two line here. Now select this line and this one. Go to sketch dimension, the angle here, 40 degrees. Go to constraints, horizontal, vertical, select this point and this one. And the distance between this line here and the midpoint is 37 over 2. Okay. Now, the distance between these two points, 14 millimeters, okay? We made this. Now let's create another line here, and the distance between this point and the midpoint is 69 over 2. So select a line, make a line here. Okay. Let's create the same sketch here. But the angle is the same and the length of this line is the same, but the distance between this line here and the midpoint will be 49 over 2. And we have the distance between these two lines here that is 2 millimeters, okay? So select the line. Okay. Now go to constraint, select equal, select these two lines, select horizontal vertical constraint, select these two points, go to sketch dimension, it's 2 millimeters here, the angle 40 degrees, select equal constraint, select these two lines here, and the length here is 6 millimeters, and the distance between this line here and this line here is 49 over 2. Now let's close the sketch here. Select this line, this point, and this point. Make this a vertical line. We made this. Okay. Now finish the sketch. Go to Revolve Features. Select this profile. The axis is this line here. We'll create this, okay? Operation new body, press okay. We made this. Now to finish this, we need to create this hole here, M6, and we'll put this in the center of this face here, okay? In the center here. So it will be 6 millimeters of a distance between the center of this hole and this edge here. So open the fusion, go to create a sketch, top plane, select the circle, make a circle here with 6 millimeters, and go to sketch dimension. The distance between this circle and the midpoint is 6 millimeters, and go to constraints, horizontal, vertical, select the circle and the midpoint, and finish the sketch. Now go to Extrude, and the extended type here, select all, operation cut, press OK. We made this, okay. And here we finish our exercise. So thanks for watching, subscribe my channel for more, and see you in the next videos. Bye bye.